Written by Patricia Lowry, presented by Caitlin Bishop, Christian Smith, Shelton Johnson, and Tamaya Lawrence. And life is full of decisions. Be mindful of the ones you choose. Thank you.
Yeah, y'all, what's up? What's the kid doing to me? I got you. You ready? You know, it's your third Miss Friday. Cole says you can't play Friday. You know my brother?
Yeah.
He never missed Friday. In 4 years, he never missed one.
And I hate you, too.
I got us a lot of tea.
When can't come over? Because I honestly might just bounce.
Man, I got $100. A whole $100.
Right.
Tell you what, we can split 50-50. I mean, I should get some of it. I did buy a ticket, you know.
Keep the money, man. It don't even matter. I'm going to catch you later.
You look serious.
I am, baby.
Oh, don't tell me. You're pregnant.
No. Well, listen, man. No questions either.
Okay.
And you can't tell Kay.
It's not like I tell her everything.
Well, shit, sometimes you do.
Okay, man.
Do you think you can get the keys to the building your dad is going to tear down?
Maybe. Why?
I really need that favor.
Maybe I shouldn't have left him there. Maybe I should have told his mom something. But shit, I don't know what to do. It all happened so fast.
I really appreciate this thing.
So you gonna tell me?
Tell you what.
Look, man, I took a risk bringing you here.
Okay. 2 weeks ago, I had to take a test.
What kind of test?
It's called the HIV antibody test. And I tested positive.
Are you saying you have AIDS? How did you get it? Who did you get it from?
I just got it, okay?
Yeah, but AIDS is not something you just get off a toilet seat, you know?
Look, there are three main ways you can get AIDS. By having sex with someone who has it and not using a rubber. Or by sharing an IV needle with someone infected. Or by a blood transfusion. But that ain't likely to happen no more because they screen the blood.
Look. I don't know what to say.
Say something.
I mean, he's standing there, 2 feet away from me, telling me he might have the AIDS virus. I mean, people die from AIDS. They don't even have a cure for it. And we having this conversation like he got caught cutting class and wants me to forge him a doctor's note.
Look, if you don't want me here, I understand. But I just need time to figure things out.
Of course I let him stay. He was my best friend. Look, Sarah, I gotta be in the class. The conference is on the tardy. I won't be able to play this week.
Where is he?
Carter? Room 209?
No, Mark.
Mark.
I think he has issues with his
fear. Well, I called his mom and she said he had a football time.
And what did you say?
I pretended I forgot about the tournament. Now, where is he?
Damn, I'm late!
Dang!
Thank you.
HIV and AIDS Factbook. Everything you need to know to protect yourself and your family. A little bit too late for me, I guess. AIDS is transmitted through sexually intercourse. What? You can't read, Marvin. AIDS is also transmitted through sharing IV needles. Check this. Fever, fatigue, or thrush. All thrush is characterized by creamy white patches on the back of the throat. That's disgusting.
Damn it, Mark!
Shh, man, do you want the whole world to hear you or not?
Why don't you tell me you were having sex with Sarah?
I mean, you don't tell me I'm playing you and Kat, do you know?
Yeah, but it's a little different for me to have sex with somebody than you. You could be carrying AIDS virus.
That ain't no business.
Did you tell Sarah you could be giving her AIDS?
I didn't.
Did you use a rubber?
Dang!
This is what you want to tell about.
I did.
Mark! So when I found you, I was so worried. Are you in trouble? I mean, God, it looks like a hike out of here. I know fighters are coming up, but come on, I'm gonna let you cheat. That was a joke. What's going on?
Go ahead, Mark. Tell her. Or don't you think that's in her business either?
Sarah, 3 weeks ago I had a fifth test. It's called the HIV antibody test. And I tested positive. But that doesn't mean you...
So, if I have it, then you got it too.
No, I don't.
What?
You're the one to talk. You could be giving her the AIDS virus.
I did it. Look, you don't have it. And that's all that's concerned.
No, I won't change
it. I'm not.
I want you out of here. Just leave your hands on me.
Oh,
no.
In a social studies class once, we played this game. The teacher said, you're the life rep. There are four of you, but there's only enough water for three. What would you do? I said I would jump out and let the others live. Duh. But when I thought I might have AIDS, it felt like I was in that raft. And I would push everybody else overboard just to protect myself.
No.
with the other two.
Of course you do. Mark and I were talking about goals. He said, my 20s, they can play hard. My 30s, they can work hard. My 40s, they can politics. I said, well, Mark, what about your 50s? He said, yeah, I can't plan that far ahead.
Look, man, I'm sorry about what happened back at your apartment. I just got scared, you know? I thought me and Sarah had it.
Yeah, that would be frightening.
Look, man, I'm trying to say something here.
Sarah explained about you guys. It don't matter now, man.
No, no, this is different. I think I know how you got it, and well, I can understand, you know, I mean, I'm not for anything, but I can understand how you might want to, you know.
You ask me if I'm gay?
I mean, if you are, you still not
hurt. Wow. Great enough. But I guess you should know I got it through your brother.
My brother's gay? So what happened?
He sold me something. One time. That's all. But we shared the same deal.
So why didn't tell me this?
Man, you know how you are about your brother?
Look, I'm sorry. I thought you got it, you know.
It don't even matter. You're my best friend, right?
Yeah?
Be careful then. You know what I'm saying? Be careful.
Oh, my God.
I was on my way to school, and I just knew. It wasn't a thought. It wasn't even a feeling. And I started getting angry with him. I was yelling at him in the car as I turned towards the hospital. Don't do it, Mark. Please, don't do it. But all the way there, I already knew.
We met in the 7th grade. I was shy because I had just moved from a really small town. And everything felt sort of awkward, but Mark, he was always so nice to me. I mean, he treated me like an actual person, and he didn't even have to. He was on the A football team, for Christ's sakes. He didn't have to say a word to me, but he always did. At the funeral, they had makeup on Mark's face, and I think they padded his suit so he wouldn't look so skinny. He weighed 84 pounds when he died. I mean, I weighed 84 pounds in the 5th grade, but they still shouldn't have padded his suit like that.
And they asked us if we wanted to say something.
Because we were his best friends.
But what is there to say when all you want is to have him here?
Goodbye, Mark.
Goodbye, Mark.
Goodbye, Mark. I love you too.